Welcome back to the African Diaspora News Channel. I am Wangil Zalalem bringing you the story. Today's story is about US Secretary telling African leaders to be cautious of China. Let me read for you what he said. He was in a meeting with Uhuru Kenyatta of Kenya and Buhari, President Buhari from Nigeria. And I found it really interesting what he told them. He said to them, you should be looking hard at whether when other countries come in to build a big infrastructure project, are they bringing their own workers with them or are they giving jobs to people in the country where they're making investments in? He also added and he said, we're not asking anyone to choose between the United States or China, but I would encourage you to ask those tough questions, to dig beneath the surface, to demand transparency and to make informed choices about what is best for you and your countries. Well, U.S. Secretary of State Antony, I would have to agree with that, 100%. My only issue is that it's you that is saying this. Yes, he said in the quote, in what I just read for you, he said something like, we don't want you Africans to choose between Chinese or us, U.S. government. We're just telling you the facts, basically. And I get what he's saying when we're giving this huge project and they're the ones building the infrastructure for us. We need to be cautious. I understand that. But the fact that he's the one saying this doesn't sit well with me, because he's saying it to make a case for the US and for them to act like they have the best intention for us and the Chinese don't. Frankly, both of them don't. Both of them are looking out for themselves. The US government for themselves, the Chinese government for themselves. So at the end of the day, there's no such thing as I'm the good cop, that's the bad cop, so choose me. No, African leaders should choose what is best for their people and their countries, not necessarily just because the US tell them, yo, I'm letting you in, Chinese, they're doing this and this and this. How about you, US? How about you? Isn't Biden doing the same thing? Wasn't he just, a few months ago telling Nigeria and Ghana if they don't allow same-sex marriage, he's going to stop the aid that they're supposed to give in? Isn't US the one that just announced that they are no longer giving Ethiopia $100 million that was supposed to come in aid, and they said no because they're like, we don't like how you're handling your internal relations and situation. So you mean to tell me Chinese are so bad and US is so good? No, sir, have several seats. We don't buy that anymore. We don't, you might tell our leaders and they might buy it. I don't even think they buy it. They just are bought themselves. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you, because I didn't take political science for a degree. I didn't study politics. And it's so, like, it's simple. You don't need to know politics for you to understand. When you sign a contract, it's supposed to be a win-win. You give me this, I give you that. It's like an exchange. The same way when you buy something, you give them the money, what you think is worth, and they give you the product. That's how the transaction should work. If we're giving you raw materials, we need to have this and this and this in return. So that's how it is supposed to be. But that's not what is going on right now, is it? So I found it very... It was hypocritical, in my opinion, for him to sit down there and tell them, you need to be careful as Africans, whatever comes your way when you give contracts, when they build this and that for you, you know, you just have to be cautious. Well, yeah, we need to be cautious, but at the end of the day, you do the same thing to us. So, come on, why are you questioning our intelligence? I mean, our leaders might act like a fool, but we're not. We're not fools. It's just, for now, we're just fighting our battles to get into that position, to get people that will do something for Africa in that place so that they can help us. So I don't get why they think we're so beneath and we can't comprehend what's going on right now, and we just sit back and say, oh wow, the US secretary said this. Yes, he's right. Chinese are taking advantage of us. Yes, they are, and you are too. So it's pretty much the same thing for me. I don't know why you're telling us this. Okay. Mm-hmm. So what are you bringing to the table that can help us, that we can help each other? We no longer want your you know, charity, because we've seen where it got us. When you see something you don't like that we do, based on our culture, whatever it is, our society is not ready for whatever you're trying to push, you stop those aids that you promised, you committed. So what does that tell us? We cannot depend on your aid. We have to depend on ourselves. So if you're coming here to tell us a business, give us something that those two countries can work with, something that you benefit us as well as we benefit you. We're done. You heard the Ghanaian president saying raw materials no longer being sent because you need to start buying it. We need to start manufacturing our own things, you know? So yeah, if, as far as I'm concerned, what he said is just a bunch of, you fill in the blanks, a bunch of dash. So yeah, okay, you told us that, good. We already know that, you do the same thing too. So that's why I was like, really, really? When I read it, I was like, okay, good for you. Anyways, guys, do let us know down below what your thoughts are on why US Secretary is telling African countries to be cautious of Chinese government. I am Miguel Zalalem bringing you the story. I will see you on the next one. Bye.
Hey family, we want to tell you about a new book written by John Almo and Patty Almo. It's called Introduction to TWE for American Diasporas. Now, the book is going to focus on helping you learn the Akan language, culture, and Ghana as a country. It's also a guide through Ghana's most widely spoken language. Now, the book is supposed to help develop your awareness of social customs, cultural practices, by combining historical, cultural, and social context with language training and grammar. This is the book that you want to pick up before you start heading for your first trip to Ghana. Pick up Introduction to TWE for American Diasporas today.
Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and download the African Diaspora News Channel app, now available on Google Play and the Apple App Store.